हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ इंसर्शन सॉर्ट। दिस इज वन ऑफ द सॉर्टिंग टेक्निक दैट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू टू सॉर्ट द गिवन सेट ऑफ वैल्यूज इन असेंडिंग ऑर्डर। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड कीप द बेल रिंगिंग। In this session, mainly I am going to explain you how to dry run the program. For this, you must know the program or the logic or the implementation of the insertion sort that I have already explained in my previous video. For your reference, I am providing you a shortcut link for the insertion sort and its implementation. Now let's start with the function, or at a glance I am going to explain you the function of the insertion sort. Let's start with the first element of the array by making it as a key. After this, we supposed to take care of the index of the sorted list as well. That will start with just the previous number of the key. So that's why j is initialized with i minus 1. We have to take care of some few things about j must be greater than or equal to 0, because your list should not be available, will not be available at the minus 1 and onwards position, at the backward position. So that's why we have to take care of j must be greater than or equal to 0, and whatever the element that you are going to compare from a sorted list with the key, that sorted list element must be greater than key. If it is greater than key, that is both the conditions are true, then we will perform the shifting wala logic. So this is the shifting logic, where the j plus 1 position, that is to the next position, we are going to assign, we are going to copy the content of array of j, and we have to perform j minus minus or decrement in j by 1 to move to the previous number for the next comparison with this while loop. If the condition is true, we will perform the shifting wala logic. Otherwise, at that position or in the next position of the j, that is array of j plus 1, we supposed to insert a key. All these things that I am going to explain you with the help of same example which I have already explained you in the solved example video, and here I am explaining the same example with the help of dry run of this particular logic of your program or a function of the insertion sort. So now let's start with the step 1, with the first we can say that the 0th element is a sorted element, and now let's compare, let's start with the first element. So now let's start with the for loop. Here I am starting with the for loop. For that I am initializing I equal to 1. Let's check the condition I is less than n, that is 5, condition is true. And let's make the key as array of I. So at the I plus 1, let's make it as a key, keep it aside and initialize j to I minus 1. So this is, here you can see that j equal to I equal to 1. So I minus 1 is equal to 0, j is equal to 0. Let's check the condition whether j is greater than or equal to 0 and array of j, that is 12, is greater than key or not. Yes, both the conditions are true, so that's why I need to apply the shifting logic. While shifting the element, what I have to do, I have to perform, I have to assign the array of j, that is 12, I have to assign at the array of j plus 1, that is array of 1 position. So now let's shift it to the next position and perform j minus 1. J equal to j minus 1, that is decrement of j by 1. So that's why j is at minus 1 position. Let's move back to the while condition. Let's check whether this while condition is true or false. Yes, you are correct. The while condition is false. So that's why exit from a while loop and let's move forward for the outer while condition. Outer while statement is nothing but insertion of the key element at j plus 1. Now why at j plus 1? Because we have decremented j in a previous condition, previous while loop. So that's why to the next position, that is 0th position, in this case we supposed to insert the key. key value. So now let's insert this key value at the array of j plus 1 position. Here we have done with the step number 1 or a pass number 1. Now let's move forward for the step number 2. In this step number 2, what we supposed to do? We supposed to pick the element from the unsorted list at the position 2. So that's why what I have to do, I have to increment I by 1 and let's check I is less than n. Yes, the condition is true. Make it as key value. Let's make array of I, that is array of 2, as a key value, and this is my key value, a new key value. Initialize j to the I minus 1, that is j is at the position 1. So here j, you can see that j equal to 1. Let's check whether the condition j is greater than or equal to 0. Yes, it is greater than or equal to 0. And let's check array of j, that is 12, is greater than key, that is 15. This second condition is false in this case, and either condition is false means we are not going to execute the statements which are available within the while loop as the condition is false, because I have used the AND operator over here. AND means both condition must be true. If either condition is false, what I will do, I will go forward for the directly insertion logic. And here in this insertion logic, at the j plus 1 position, that is j is at 1 position, j plus 1, that is at the second position, we supposed to insert a key value. So their shifting is not required in this case, and 15 will be placed at this position only. So now let's move forward for once more the for loop, that is let's pick the next element from the unsorted list in the step number 3. Here again I plus plus, I is less than 5, condition is true. Let's make array of I, that is array of 3, that is 5, as a key value. Then let's keep it aside. J we have to initialize to the minus 1 position, minus I position, that is j equal to 2. Let's check the condition whether j is greater than or equal to 0. Yes, it is 2, that's why condition is true. And array of j, that is 15, is greater than key. Yes, this condition is also true. Both the conditions are true, that's why enter into the while loop and let's execute array of j plus 1 equal to array of j. That is nothing but we supposed to perform the shifting logic. Let's shift this 15 to the next position. Yes, I have shifted it. Decrement j by 1. Let's initialize j equal to 1. Let's go back to the while loop again. So now let's check j is greater than or equal to 0. Yes, the condition is true, as well as array of j, that is nothing but 12, is greater than key. Yes, both the conditions are true. Again, perform the array of j plus 1 equal to array of j, that is nothing but shifting of 12 to the next position. Let's shift it. Yes, I have shifted it. Let's execute the next statement, that is j equal to j minus 1, that is decrement j by 1. So now j is initializing at j at 0 position. Let's go back to the while loop again. Let's check j is equal to greater than or equal to 0. Yes, condition is true, as well as array of j, that is 8, is greater than key, that is 5. Yes, the condition is true. Both the conditions are true, that's why enter into the while loop, and let's shift array of j to the next position. So now let's execute this statement by shifting array of j to the next position and decrement j by 1. Let's j by 1 is decremented by 1. Here you can see that. After that, let's go back to the while condition. Now let me know the condition is true or false. The condition is false, as j is not greater than or equal to 0. If any of the condition is false, we need to stop at this position. We need to exit from the while condition, while loop, and let's execute the next statement to the while loop. Let's execute this statement. So this statement is array of j plus 1 equal to key. This is nothing but the insertion of the key element at j plus 1 position. Why at j plus 1 position? Because we have already decremented j to the previous position, and we supposed to insert a new value or the key value at the 0th position, which is next to the minus 1 position. So now let's insert these to the next the zeroth position, and here you can see that after insertion your sorted array will be having four values. Now let's move forward for the next step, that is step number 4. In the step number 4, let's pick the next value from the unsorted list. Let's check the condition I is less than n. Yes, I is at the after performing I++, I is at the fourth position, I is less than 5, condition is true. Let's make this array of I, that is 10, as a key value, keep it aside, and let's initialize j to I minus 1. So here j is equal to 3. Let's check the condition of a while loop. J is greater than or equal to 0. Yes, the condition is true, and array of j, that is 15, is greater than key, that is 10. Yes, the condition is true, means both the conditions are true. Let's enter into the while loop for performing shifting of the array of j to the next position. So let's shift this 15 to the next position. Yes, I have shifted it, and after that decrement j by 1. After decrementing j by 1, j will be at position 2. Let's move backward to the while condition again. Let's check whether j is greater than or equal to 0. Yes, and array of j, that is 12, is greater than 10, that is key value. Yes, both the conditions are true. Let's enter into the while loop to perform the shifting. Yes, I have shifted the array of j to the array of j plus 1 position, that is to the next position. Let's decrement j by 1. Let's initialize j to 1, and now let's go back again to the while loop to check the condition, that is j is greater than or equal to 0. The condition is true. Let's check the another condition, as array of j, that is 8, is greater than key, that is 10. Is the condition true? No, the condition is false. And if either condition is false, means we are not going to enter into the while loop. We will exit from a while loop and we will execute a next statement to the while loop is nothing but the insertion of the key at j plus 1 position. So now let's insert the key at j plus 1 position. Here you can see that already the space is available with us for the insertion of the element, that is key element. Let's insert it to the position j plus 1, that is at position 2, because j is at 1, j plus 1 is position 2, and it is inserted at this position. So in this way we have executed the program. Now let's what we have to do, we need to go back to the while loop, to the for loop again. I will perform I++. Now I will be having value 5, and I is less than 5, that is n. 5 is less than 5, this condition is false, and we supposed to stop at this position. So now let's we have done with the dry run of the insertion sort with the help of the same example which I have already explained in the solved example wala video. Thank you all dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the video, please do not forget to give the comment here for your reference. I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel Tech Talks. Please do subscribe my channel Tech Talks. For your reference, again I am providing you a shortcut link for the next video of this video series, along with the whole video series in the form of playlist of the insertion sort. So I hope all of you are enjoying the sorting techniques with the Tech Talks. Stay tuned with Tech Talks. Happy learning. Thank you.